I'm starting a side band called Hill Country Review, and I'm gonna definitely bring in Gary Burnside, possibly Dwayne too. It just depends on if he wants to do it. I think he does though. He's been calling me a lot lately. He's a really talented dude, man. He's so Dwayne's a trip, man. It just oozes out of him. But yeah, a couple other guys. It's got Kirk Smithhart from Memphis and Chris. As long as he wants to play bass, you know. And we're gonna go do some residency shows in the Southeast. But yeah, we're gonna get together in March and record an EP real fast, and it'll probably be all original blue stuff, you know.
Tell me about Dwayne's record, Red Rooster, man.
I produced a record on Dwayne last year. It was crazy. It's really, really good, but I don't know if it's going to come out. It's one of those things. It's just like it's gotten hung up in a bunch of different, in between the label and the manager and Dwayne. It's just sort of, it's on the shelf at the moment. But it was certainly fun to make, and it's a real creative, great record. Cody Burnside comes in and does some freestyle rapping that's pretty amazing. They're just such a talented family, you know, and that's basically what he's rapping about, just like the Burnsides and their name and everything.
Their record's off the hook.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool. A lot of good originals on there. He covered Circle in the Sky, one of Luther's songs that he played with us, which I thought was funny.
He killed it. It's way better than our version.
It's a cool record. It'll come out eventually, called Red Rooster, you know. Crow for day. Music to the sun, cause the bus is steady. We'll get down, can't get enough. It's great.